This is table four. We're going to cover this cerebrum. So a gyrus is one of these little worm-like projections. A plural for gyrus is gyri. And then a sulcus is one of these indentations. And plural for that, many would be sulci. So the gray matter, also we have in the gray matter. Gray matter is on the outside of the brain. We would also call that the cerebral cortex. And then the white matter is located within the inside of the brain. Now, cerebral hemispheres, we have a right hemisphere and a left hemisphere that go together. In lecture, you'll learn kind of how cool these work together. But you have right hemisphere, left hemisphere. Then we have the longitudinal fissure. I guess I should leave that together. The cerebral longitudinal fissure is that huge groove in between the right and left hemisphere. Now, what connects the right and left hemisphere is what's called our corpus callosum. So we can see that once we open it up as this white layer right here. Our frontal lobe is going to be marked by, we have several sulci. So really what we're looking for is a sulcus that goes almost all the way down to this lobe down here and all the way up. This is called the central sulcus. And everything in front of this is called the frontal lobe. Now I'm going to show you this color-coded one just to be able to make it clear for the video. But here we have our central sulcus. We have a grouping of gyri right in front of it. That this is called our pre-central gyrus because it's in front of pre. And then the blue would be our post-central gyrus, meaning behind it. So both of those are on either side of our central sulcus. Now our parietal lobe is this, not that guy, it's back here. So on this guy, back to our central sulcus, our parietal lobe is back here, coming back. And if you remember, our parietal bone is much bigger than our parietal lobe. And then we already did post-central gyrus, but after that, the parieto-occipital sulcus can actually truly only be found if we're looking at the sagittal view. And there should be a sulcus located right here. This is actually kind of man-made because these come apart. So let me show you on a real cadaver brain here, if I can find a good one. So right here, you don't get to do this at home, but right here, I don't know if you can see, I didn't make that, but do you see how there's this true sulcus that's separating that from that? And so this is our parieto-occipital sulcus right there, separating parietal lobe from occipital lobe. And in the back, then we have the occipital lobe. Now our lateral sulcus is what's found on the outer portion of the brain, right here. And our lateral sulcus separates the frontal lobe from the temporal lobe. So on a real brain, we can kind of see this has lots of vessels and things hiding in it, but if I can open those up, we can see that temporal lobe here and the lateral sulcus and then the frontal lobe. Now our septum fornix is going to be this lower layer under the corpus callosum, and that's also white. So on the real brain, we see a little bit of it left over right there. On this one that still has all of it, you can see that fornix right there. So here's our corpus callosum up there, and here's our fornix down here. And then the septum pellucidum, this side still has it. This is this sheath, this layer. Septum meaning a separation. So we have something like a nasal septum, which is gonna separate two cavities. This is separating both of our lateral ventricles. So inside here, we have a lateral ventricle. And then on this side of the septum pellucidum, we would have another lateral ventricle. The cerebral nuclei, I'm not gonna be able to show you on any of these models or cadavers. So look for tables and pictures and images in the practice quizzes for that. It usually just involves a dark coloration, but we need a coronal view that can show that. And then there's the lateral ventricles. So here, this side is open, but you can actually see into one side of the lateral ventricles right there. And this model also has lateral ventricles right here and here, showing you both of those.